said, "Yes, Lord, I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." These words of Martha in the Gospel today are the words that Mom has professed in this life and continues to profess in the life after this. Mom believed in Christ as Lord, and today we entrust her to his love and mercy. On behalf of Dad and my family, I want to thank you all for your love and prayers these past couple of weeks. I admit it seems weird to say this because we're all family here, and I know that many of your own extended families and friends have been expressing their own condolences to you, and I'm sure you feel in your own heart the same gratitude towards them. As a priest, one of the tools that we use when preparing a homily is the experiences that we have, and drawing out of these experiences connections to our spiritual lives. I guess one of the benefits of being a priest in Nebraska is that I can use a lot of family experiences without the fear of getting in trouble from Mom and Dad and my siblings. But yes, I use a lot of my own growing up families and stories of many of my homilies back in Nebraska. And today I'd like to use a couple of these family experiences that I tend to use with my students and parishioners as we pray for Mom, but also as we come before God, as we strive to grow in our own life with Christ, to grow deeper in our relationship with the Lord. When I prepare couples for marriage, one of the points I emphasize with them is that even when children come into the picture, they need to continue growing their relationship with each other and their friends. And I tell them the story. When Dad had a stroke about 11 years ago, Mom became his caretaker. There was a point in their lives where their life became so monotonous that even when I would speak to Mom on the phone, there was that sound of a hopelessness, a purposelessness. And each time I would call, I would encourage Mom, Mom, go out, Dad, go walking around the city, go walking at the mall or at the shopping center, encourage her, go to the movies, watch a movie, go call your friends. Hopelessness and purposelessness, I would hear in Mom's voice. And after several months and attempts at encouraging her to do these things, she finally said to me one day, "You know, Joe, when you kids were growing up, Mom and Dad devoted ourselves to you. We drove you to all your activities, and we didn't even get together with our friends that much. How am I supposed to call them up now and ask them to get together?" And then that really broke my heart. But I realized how devoted Mom and Dad were to us, their kids. Mom was certainly a devoted woman. I've only known her to work in that same building, although it changed Bank of America, Bank of Hawaii, and she retired from that same place. She was devoted to that work. She married her high school sweetheart, even though Tasha Cruz was not too fond of him at the beginning. Dad said he kind of gave them a hard time. They had 5 kids in 6 years. As I work with families now, I appreciate more and more the fact that they had 5 kids in 6 years right after marriage. In their weakness, they attempted to go to grandkids' school events and sporting events. And in these last several years, she had Sisters' Day on Thursdays. What a blessed time those were, as I enjoyed watching the videos of Mom and her sister just enjoying themselves, doing all sorts of crazy sister things that they do. And truth be told, I love to watch those videos just to hear that mafumfum cackle, that mafumfum laughter. But she was so, so devoted to her family, to her husband, to her work, to her siblings. Mom's devotedness is just a small glimpse of our Heavenly Father's devotedness to us. In the second reading today, St. John says, "See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God." God is so devoted to us that He calls us His sons and daughters. That is who we are. And there's no sin that we can commit that would change that reality. Our Father is always calling us to Himself. He's always calling us to live as His sons and daughters, calling us to live His commandments and His will, because these lead to the greatest happiness, that life with Him forever and ever. Today, that is what we pray for Mom, that she may have the greatest happiness, that life with her Father. Every year on January 3rd, which is the Feast of the Holy Name of Jesus, and on September 12th, the Feast of the Holy Name of Mary, I always preach in my parish at Pisan High School, where I teach about what Mom taught us growing up. She taught us that we should bow our heads at the name of Jesus and Mary. Mom had such an inspiring love for Jesus and Mary, that out of reverence for these powerful names, we should bow our heads, she said. I admit that as much as I use these names in prayer, in teaching, and conversation, I don't always bow my head. But I do strive to do it, especially during this greatest prayer, this prayer of the Mass. Mom had a devoted love to Mary and the world's womb. My earliest memories include Sunday family rosaries, all of the five kids leading around Mom and Dad's bed. And in these last several years, Mom's day always began with her morning prayers, which included the rosary and many different chaplets, after reciting a growing list of names that she wanted to pray for. This past year, it was difficult for me to get home with Mom. I'll usually call about 3 o'clock in the Sunday afternoon, and most times I missed. And there will be weeks will go by and I didn't talk to them, but because she wouldn't hear the phone ringing, and I'm smart, I thought, I'm going to call at 7:30 a.m. because Mom would be praying every morning with her phone, and she would see me call. And it worked like a charm. I always got a chance to talk to her when I called that early because she was praying. Our love for Christ can only be complete if we have a true devotion to His Mother Mary. At the foot of the cross, Christ said to Mary, "Behold your son, behold your children." At the same time, Christ told us, "Behold your mother." Mary only wants to lead us to a deeper love for Son, that we may share all eternity with Him. Today, that is what we pray for Mom, that she may not have this life with Jesus and Mary, whom she loves so dearly. It truly is a joy to be able to celebrate this funeral mass for Mom during this time of quarantine and social distancing. As much as we want many of our extended families and friends to be with us this afternoon here for this funeral mass, to pray for Mom and to pray for us because of the restrictions and regulations, I am grateful to Almighty God for giving us this opportunity to give Mom what she desired, the mass. The tomorrow custom of praying the rosary after death for 18 days is uniquely a beautiful custom. And remember, Mom loved Mary. But even at that, Mom told us that she just wants Mass. She just wants Mass. She loved the Mass. She loved the church where Mass was celebrated. She loved the priests who offered those Masses. When Mom became secretary here to Are they at peace and same journey? I saw a genuine love of these three things grow in mommy. She loved her job here. And the priest loved having her. As Father Carl said, he tried to keep mom on his secretaries as long as he could. Eventually, because of the help of taking care of dad, she retired. And she wasn't at the house. No one said, check the church. She's not here at the house of the church. That's usually where she was. As I was not serving here in Guam, mom took on the priests and seminarians and deacons who came through this church as her sons. And she would pray for them by name each morning. Working here also gave her the opportunity to attend Mass more regularly until her and dad were going daily. She was fed at the Mass. And as she was fed, she wanted more of the graces that flowed from her here. I like to believe that the wish for Mass was mom's gift to us. Because at every Mass that we gather, all of God's family, all the saints, all the angels, all the servants of souls in purgatory, they all gather at every single Mass at the altar to praise the Lord and to worship the Lamb that was slain. At every Mass, they're all here. At every Mass, we are closest to our loved ones that we have lost because they gather with us at the altar of God. I believe her wish just for Mass was her gift to us. Well, Mom, you got your wish. You got your wish as we gathered here for this Mass. But not only us, all the saints and angels, all of our beloved deceased, non-intoxicants, young grandma, they're all here. But also, Archbishop George Lucas of Omaha, Bishop James Conley of Lincoln, Bishop David of Westminster, and Bishop Robert Finn, along with over 100 priests of Lincoln, and Father Carl, Father Mike, my twin, Father Mike, who I am grateful for being here along with the desire, praying for you and offering this Mass for you. At this great moment in Lincoln, some of my brother priests are also offering Mass for her at this time. This is probably why the Lord gave Mom a son that he would call to be a priest, that I would continue offering Mass for her throughout my life. We do not stop praying for our loved ones in death. Heaven is not assured for any of us. At my first Mass of Thanksgiving after my priestly ordination, I gave to Mom a cloth called the Manchurian. During the viewing, you saw that cloth in her hand. This cloth was used to wipe the sacred chrism off my hands at ordination. The tradition is that our mothers are buried with this cloth, as she still has it in her casket, around their hands. And then when she comes before Christ in judgment, she would offer him this cloth, asking him for mercy. For she gave him a son as a priest. I heard some of the aunties wanted to cut a piece of that old cloth off. Sorry, aunties. things doesn't work that way. I checked the clock, it's still warm. And even with this, we do not stop praying for love and all our beloved sins. This is the greatest gift we can offer them. Our prayers that our Father will have mercy on them and welcome them into his kingdom. God has been so good to mom. And I pray that he will give her now her greatest desire, that life with him forever. Eternal rest, grant unto you.